Okay, so I want to install a PyCharm. So go to the PyCharm download. Okay, JetBrains download PyCharm. Already I told in previously. Again I am telling, community. Make sure that you are download from community, guys. Some people are having a finger energy allergy kind of stuff. Something they show colorful, they'll click on that one only. So it is showing blue and this is black. So immediately they don't like black and they will don't select it. Okay, so this one is okay. This is toolbox app. Toolbox app contains all other tools of PyCharm products. Okay, yeah, just you have to click on download, then you will download it. So once you click on it, already I downloaded here. So this one, okay, and I copied. Already I keep this PyCharm community 20.21.1.exe. This is around 360-370 MB size. So okay. Not only this one, so you can go to any developer's tools for a different kind of stuff. Kscala, REST, Ruby, Mine, Ruby Mine also there here. PHP Storm, IntelliJ IDEA, Golang. Okay, different IDEs and application kind of stuff is there. Some are free, some are trial versions also possible. Okay, so this is how we can download. First, download it. Already I downloaded it and I keep it in my folder. Okay, so here this PC. So to install this one, we need a Java. Install this one, we need a Java. So I will install the Java also. So this is very, it's become more important. So first of all, forget about PyCharm, and first we have to install the Java thing. I will show Java installation and Java environmental variable settings and one program execution. So first up, we will see that one. So forget PyCharm again, we'll see. That is important. Here I want to do today a lot of things. What are the lot of things I want to do? So I want to install Jenkins also. To install a Jenkins, certain Java JDK versions support, certain JDKs won't support. Okay, to run a Java application, we need a JRE. To run an any application, okay, so to run any Java application, so application we need a JRE. But you want to develop an application and that environment you want it, you need a JDK. JDK means Java Development Kit and JRE means Java Runtime Environment. So we need a JDK to this one. So normally if you download and install a JDK, you will get JRE also. In JDK, we have a JRE. So I'm going with a JDK. But which version? So there are different versions of JDKs are there. So 8 is there, 9 is there, 10 is there. Popular 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Like that, so many are there. So the latest version of JDK, you can install directly. So like JDK download, just JDK download. You can download from Oracle. Now Java, actually Java is developed by Sun Microsystem, but now it is under Oracle only. Sun Microsystem is under Oracle only. So simple. This is a SC16 standard editions. You can download enterprise edition also. You can download enterprise editions. 16 is latest releases and 11 is a platform here, so you can download those things. 8, sometimes when you download latest version, it won't ask you anything, means no need to give a username and password. But if you are download and install, okay, if you are download and install of previous editions, it may ask you for a username and password also possible. Okay, this is a JE8, means Java 8, JDK 8, and this is a 11. But point is, I want to install today Jenkins also. So this is a Jenkins.io. I type Jenkins.io. Magnifier, I closed it. Where is this magnifier? Today all are late only. Okay, Jenkins.io. Now I want to download Jenkins. It will show two things for downloading. So this is a LTS, means long term support. Okay, this is a latest one. So guys, when you see the latest number, don't download. See the LTS. Okay, LTS means longer. It will support stable version. It is not a stable version. Okay, so this is a .jar var file. So you can we are downloading this one only. Okay, also we can deploy in a cloud also. Okay, this is the file I want to download, but we need a specifications. Not now. Happened to that? Not now. Okay, so I want to see like a minimum requirements for installing kind of stuff, like hardware and software requirements. Okay, so for installing in Linux, I want to install Warfire. So what is the hardware requirements, and also Java requirements is also important here. So you can see Java requirements page. So it is works on a Windows 8 runtime environment, both 32-bit and 64-bit. Okay, and next, Java 11 also support. See, 8 support, 11 support, 9 and 10 and 12 not support. So better not to use these two versions. Older versions of not working means 7, 6 not working here. Okay, 8 works with Jenkins, 11 works with a Jenkins. Okay, so either you choose Java 11 or a 8. 8 supports so many things. 8 support lot of kind of stuff. Okay, so you can download 8 or a 7 or 11 also. Like if you want 11, so you can download JDK download. Okay, it's a JDK 11 download. It is there, and you can see which edition. So I am going to Windows 64 installer. This is the 152 MB. Okay, .exe file download. Yes, download. Don't worry, it will ask you what it will ask. It is asking Oracle account. Guys, if you don't have Oracle account, don't worry, you can create an account. You can create an account, any secondary account or primary account, whatever the account you will decision only. Any account you can use it, Gmail or any account you can use it. For basic download, you don't require a company account. Like if you want to download operating system kind of stuff, then you need a company account. But here, normal user accounts are enough. I have my own account, so I forget my account. Yeah, I didn't forget my account, and I put this thing also in my DevOps folder. So download. So this is a 11, JDK 11. If you want 8, you can also download a 8 also. Okay. How you download? How what you will do in your state? Okay. Okay. So for you, again. Okay, it is downloaded. Okay, so if in case if you have a problem to sign in kind of stuff, no problem. Just I'm keeping things into here only. Why am what I'm doing like this? Okay, so I'm uploading into Google Drive. Okay, so then you can access my from here in this link in Google Drive link only. So OS Drive folder. So that is your I'm giving completely to you. So then you can access things from anywhere. If you want anything, documents or application, if you cannot able to download from your Windows, right, you can do it. Okay, so this is my drive. I copied in there only, so next time you can access from here. Okay, so this is 11. I downloaded. If you want 8, I will give you 8 also, no problem. So here I'm using JDK 11. So JDK 11 supported by Jenkins. 11 and 8 will support by Jenkins. I use 8. Okay. What happened? Refresh. Now see, whatever I keep it in my physical machine, say it will be showing my virtual machine directly. So I don't need to be download here and there also. I didn't install Google Chrome and not it, so I will install it later. Okay, so one time you install and keep it in one place, then you can do it. Now I'm installing JDK 11. Yes. Today we'll see all the installations only. So once system is having all the applications, no need to confuse. So you can do directly. Next. So like this, everything is selected or not, you have to check it. So both are there, source code and development tools. This is the path, installation path. If you want to change the path, you can change it also, but better not to change it. It's a 64 bit anyway. Okay, so this is 64 bit. What is it is include both JDK and JRE. Space is for 420 MB is required in a hard disk drive. So this is I keep this path only, so I'm not changing the path. So no need to change the path also, not required. But remember the path, because we have to create what we have to create environmental variables. Paths are important. So important thing in a IT means software related things, environmental variables are very important. Okay, what is environmental variable means? Where is your application? By default your system will so this is next steps. or you can close it also. If you want to go to next steps, then it will give you other guideline, help tutorials kind of stuff on it. Otherwise, you can close it, no problem. Okay, I clicked on it. Okay, now I installed successfully Java. Okay, so I'm going to CMD. Okay, this is my CMD. So I put a Java hyphen version. Some are having hyphen V, some are version, always confused between them. Yeah. Now it is showing 11.0.11, 11.0.11, and when it is, it's the latest one. Okay, so this is the build versions. If you got any problem later, so we'll see that one problems. Okay, VM version is 18.9. So we'll see. Okay, if you got in future any problem, then we'll remove this one and we'll put a old one. Okay, so this is a how to check the Java version. Java version. If it is showing like this, it means so we can run a Java program directly on the machine. So that is one thing. Yeah, JDK home, the language, libraries, questions and all. Not required anything. Now, next. I told you how I will show you a simple Java program. But guys, I need a little bit help because I don't like Java program writing part. So you can use different things in a Java, like I put a j1.java. I removed the entire thing including .txt and I put a j1.java. Now it is become Java file. Earlier it is text file, now it is Java file. Right click, edit. You can edit in a notepad. Okay, so you can define things like classes kind of stuff. So class is a J1. Here we don't have any different classes. Okay. I forget. Very good. Forget a Java, simple Java program, I forget. I need a hello world. I need that one. I don't need more ones. Okay, I told other things like Java T point also will give a lot of different things. Okay, where it is, see, in Python we can type very simply, but here in this one it's a very difficult. So instead of simple, I put a J1, that's it. Hello Java, so I'm not changing anything. I'm saving it, that's it. Okay, this is the program. So for to print hello Java, you have to write these many lines. Object oriented programming language. So see, this is Java. Next, I'm going to file. Oh, it is showing this one only. Okay, it is a new one, right? So it is remote that CMD part. It's okay. Already CMD is there. CMD. Okay, so I'm going to CD. Okay, now I'm in the directory. Now I have to type Java C J1.java. First one is we should compile. When you compile a Java, okay, when you compile a Java, it creates a class file here. It create a class file here. Okay, so Java C for compiling Java code. First we have to compile. Once you are compiled, it will create a class file. So we have to execute that one only. Okay, we are executing that one. So you need to type dot class, simply it will understand J1. Okay, it is become as class like Java J1. So hello Java, like that. Okay, class file will be created. If in case in the file the class name is different, for example here it is a Java J1 is I given, for example as a earlier it is a sample name is there, no, sample one. So I'm keeping that one only now. So see, again I am compiling my Java code. So, okay, Java C J1 dot Java, J1 dot Java. I am compiling J1 file and C class file is created. So which is the main class, based on that class first we are dividing. Either it is a single class file, means that class only. If you have multiple class, then you will get a public class. Which one is public in your structure, that is only will come, or a first one. Mostly first one is a public class. Okay, so the class file is created. Now if I want to run it, so I have to run it like this, sample one dot Java. Okay, so this is class. So to avoid this confusion, we given a always same name, we giving always same name. Okay, how we can execute a Java and all of it. So to, if you need like a, you need a different development environments, IDE type like Apache or Eclipse, so anything you can use it for a Java related one. Okay, next one is environmental variables, right? That is also there. Environment, this came early. So environmental variables, select environmental variables, see this path. If path is already added, so we'll see. It is showing a common files Oracle Java Java path only, but original Java 11 path is not added here. Original path is not added. This is a common files path only, it is added. That's why you can able to execute it. But sometimes it will give you a problem also. When you are installing some application, Java based application, it may not be work. Okay, so what I want to do is, first I want to locate where is my Java is installed in programming. It's a 64, so 64 means it is there, 32 means it is there, it's 64. Program files Java, and this is a JDK 11 like this. Okay, so this is your error. So this is a bin file, actually Java executable file stores here only. Inside a bin you can see .exe files, java.exe, javac.exe and other .exe files. You can see java.exe, javac.exe like this. Okay, so I'm copying this path. I will put a bin path later, but I'm copying this path. This is a main home directory. Under this one only we have a remaining things, right? For example, if you have a 2-3 versions, 2-3 versions of Java is there. 2-3 versions you can see from here also. Got it? 2-3 versions like a Java 8, Java 9, Java 11, Java 12. I install, then those will be display on this part only. So program files Java, Java JDK 11, JDK 8, JDK 9, JDK 10, like that it will show. Okay, but this is JDK 11 main path. So which one is Java home, you have to define it compulsory. If in case, even like if you have a 2-3 different JDKs are there, this is more helpful. So in a system variables only I'm adding. See how I'm adding environmental variables. New, first for every application or anything, like different thing, Oracle underscore home, Java underscore home, EM2 underscore home, like the different home directories are there. So you have to tell this is your home directory. Okay. Java underscore home and give the that path JDK 11 path. Next. Next one is this one. Here, whenever you create a Java home, okay, like this, and here in a path you have to add a thing also. Like you can give percentage Java underscore home percentage slash bin small letters. Okay. So you can give like this, because under Java home directory we have a bin file. You can give like this, or you can give directly. So if you got any problem, then we'll see. So you can give like this and slash bin. You can give like this, or you can give direct path like this. Open the bin, give this path entirely into that path. Just copy this path. What happened? Nobody coming earlier. Okay. No. There is two questions are there. I will tell questions and answers. So one second, one. So I open a bin file. Completely copy and go to path. Edit or a new, and you can put it like this also. Either one you can able to use it, either this or this you can use it. Both are not required, so you can remove any of this one like that. Okay, so I'm removing this one percentage kind of stuff and keeping this one like this also. You can put it, both are same. Okay, to show you how to do this this way and that way. Now the environmental variables are set. So then I'm closing this CMD. Open CMD again. Okay, same it is showing. So now one, because same application, only one application is there. Because some people ask one question, here it is. Yes. First of all, why JDK JRE required for Python? Not required for running a Python application or a Python. So we need a Python application only. We don't require a JRE and JDK for Python. Okay. To install a PyCharm application, to install a PyCharm application, we need a JDK. Second, to install Jenkins kind of application, Jenkins and Jenkins kind of application, we need a JDK. We need a JDK. Next, why we need those JDK? What is the use of that one? It is a part of DevOps, CI by CD, continuous integration and continuous deployment purpose. Jenkins is a tool, one of the tool used in CI tool, mainly continuous integration tool in a DevOps. So to learn that one, we have to install a Jenkins. So that's why I told better to install a proper JDK version, which is support for a different application. Like you want to install Oracle application, you want to install a other applications. So the Java should be supported for this one and as well as that one. So better I will use like that, instead of installing a random Java. So know which edition we have to install it. Okay. That's it.